It's certainly starting to get cold now, even down here in the valley, so I'm going to show you some tricks for how to stay warm with a bivy bag and a poncho tarp, and with a secret weapon, which is actually a ghillie blanket. I'm going to show you in a minute how that whole thing works, and then we'll see how comfortable we can make it for ourselves, yeah? So let's talk a little bit about the ghillie blanket. Of course, first and foremost, it's an object of camouflage, and it does that very well here, as you can see. But if you, and this is, I mean, this is a cheap, totally cheap Miltech 40 euro ghillie blanket. I cut it in half, I put a slit here so I can wear it as a poncho or a poncho liner, and actually just like this already, it's also pretty warm. It's actually a very good heat trapping layer, and if you wear it actually like a poncho, then you can also use it as a poncho liner. So here I have a rain poncho. So now I'm wearing this ghillie blanket actually as a poncho liner, and underneath this poncho it then traps a lot of air. Keeps me very, very comfortable, and also it keeps the moisture that comes from my body and from the sweating away from my clothing. So of course the poncho will catch that moisture eventually, but we want it as far away from our body as possible. So just with this liner on under here, already very warm. Already a lot of captured air in here. You can see how it's puffing up the poncho, and this actually makes a huge difference to warmth. So you can already be a lot more comfortable wearing your poncho if you take a ghillie blanket with you. The thing is totally roll, you can roll it up very, very small. It's very compact, it doesn't really weigh an awful lot. And as you'll see in a bit, there's a lot of other things that you can also do with it. But the first and foremost warm type of technique is basically just to wear it as a poncho liner. You can wear it with the tassels to the outside or the inside. I actually have a ghillie blanket that is fire resistant, because what I like to do when it is cold and I like to sort of settle in to watch something in nature, or just basically to be out underneath the poncho, is that I'll take a a candle lantern and a steel and a metal pot, put the candle lantern inside the pot like this, and light it to generate a lot of heat. Now the reason I use a candle lantern is because I then know exactly where the open flame is, and with this particular one, which is a Uko full size, it fits very well in this Crusader cup, and it allows me to manage, lift and drop the candle in. I always know where it is. Clearly you can also do this with a tea light, and the tea light is the basis for the sacket setup. But for just really sitting around outside and having a little bit more peace of mind, I like this setup, because I basically just know where the flame is. So I'm going to just sort of settle down. Of course you can also, and what you should do if you're going to spend any time sitting down, is make yourself a hot water bottle. So you will have some kind of means of making fire, or perhaps you have a stove with you or whatever. But make this water bottle up and put it inside your poncho against your body. So put it in your pocket of your loden, or put it against your femoral artery. The water bottle is not only, or the hot water bottle is not only for sleeping, it's for any time that you need to stay warm. So you can also basically do the same thing with the hot rocks from your fire. There, just you have to make sure that you have something to carry them in, and there a wool or merino scarf is quite handy, because that can manage quite some heat. But my test is for hot rocks, if they're too hot or just right, if I can pick them up and hold them indefinitely with a thin pair of leather gloves, then they're okay for me to have inside of my poncho setup, inside of my clothing, and it makes a huge, huge difference. Just a couple of fist-sized rocks on your femoral arteries, 3 or 4 hours of heat, vastly, vastly better. You can even take baked potatoes or something with you from home, but have some external heat source that you can use when you're sitting around and, you know, maybe you're observing the game or whatever it is that you're doing, sitting outside, looking at and sitting still. Just make sure that you're warm, because your brain doesn't work right when you're cold. You get distracted and it just basically doesn't feel so good. So, how to do? Trusty Z-rest, always. Sit on there. Get my little microclimate sorted out here. Get my candle lantern squared away. Get my feet in a good position. Get the candle lantern where I can see it, where I know where it is. And here, very important that you have the fringes, this loose stuff, away from the fire. Even though the fire is very safe, because as we said before, we have the flame stopper and all that kind of stuff, it's great, but you still have to be careful with things hanging down. So you want the fringes on the outside, then you get your candle down here so that you know where it is and so that you can warm your hands on it. And what I do is I sit inside of this thing. I sit with roughly with my hands like this, unless I'm glassing. I sit with my hands like this so that I always can tell where the fire is, so where the candle flame is. So then I pull this over my legs like that. You can see miles away from the candle. If you're worried about it, put it over your feet. Take the other layer of poncho, put that out here. Bring your arms inside, and now you can be actually very, very warm and comfortable for quite prolonged periods of time. You can sit like this if you have a candle for hours, and of course you can imagine that you can let the surrounding nature around you come to rest. You just fade and become part of the baseline. Nobody really notices you anymore, and you are very, very well cozy and set up. So that is about sitting still and using a ghillie blanket to help you be warmer. Of course, you can use the ghillie blanket on the outside of your poncho for increased concealability and so on and so forth. So obviously my Atax AU is not really quite the right color for this autumnal vegetation. Something with brown in it, more brown in it, like Flecktarn, would be much better. But again, I can have a variety of ghillie blankets cut down like this. These ponchos are dead cheap. I can have a variety of those in different camo options. So for the sake of 40 euros, now I've got several different kinds of camo that I can use. And then I don't have to keep changing out my ponchos, which are quite a lot more expensive. But that helps a lot. Of course, you can also sit on this thing. Makes an awesome, comfortable, big, 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 foofy cushion to sit on if you're needing to sit anywhere for any length of time. It's a great thing. So, and about the Z-rest. I almost always, even on a day trip, carry this 3/4 length Z-rest. It makes such a good living space. You're off the floor, you can sit with your butt and your legs, or with your lower back against something cold. It's worth the weight and the volume that it takes up. Also, and I've said this before about this, if you need to do something that's delicate with small parts, if you do it above here, it's got all these little indentations, and if you then lose a bit, it's not flashing off into the forest somewhere or into the snow where you're with no hope of finding it. Rather, it gets trapped in these little pockets, and I think that's quite handy. So, if you want to get really fancy about staying warm, then I actually would recommend this thing. This is Hill People Mountain Serap, it's called. It's a sort of a mega poncho liner, great coat, light sleeping bag. And this way, I don't need to take a heavy sleeping bag, even when it starts to get quite cold. So you might have seen previously I was up in Stubai and it was -8, I was in a zero sleeping bag. The next step from that would not be for me to take a warmer sleeping bag, but actually would be for me to take something like this. It's a durable water repellent. Basically, it will shed snow, it will shed rain to a certain extent. It's certainly completely windproof. And as you can imagine, if you have this thing on and a poncho, you don't have any worries. You just basically wear this as a poncho liner. Yeah, you get your poncho on over the top of that. You get your hood up. And you can imagine either sitting down or walking with this lot on, you will be warm. What I like very much about this garment or this thing, this mountain serap, is that now I can wear it as a poncho. I put my belt around it, and now I've basically got a great coat. This thing, like I say, is water repellent and certainly very windproof, and it's very, very warm. So if I were to just pick a bigger sleeping bag, that's fine, but I can only use it as a sleeping bag. So what I'd much rather do is to keep my light summer sleeping bag, which is also easier to pack, and take this thing, because this, together with the poncho, potentially together with the Ghillie blanket, allows me to get really heavily armored up for walking out in very bad weather. So you can get this thing all the way down to your legs. You can really tighten it up. Okay, so in this setup, with a halfway decent pair of gloves, I'm basically bomb-proof. I'm stormproof. I can walk. I can have my backpack on. All I have to do to sit down and be comfortable sat down is basically just to sit down, because the poncho is also covering my behind. It's coming all the way down my legs, and so this permits me to have maximum use of both the volume and the grams that I'm taking, and it allows me to take very small backpacks into pretty cold places and be totally secure, essentially. So the backpack is filled only with items that have at least two uses. So I'm actually too hot in this now, even though it's quite cold out here today. So I'm going to take this stuff off, and then I'm going to show you some more cool things to do with a poncho and the Ghillie blanket. So this is the kind of thing that I would build with a poncho if I were really expecting some very pretty nasty weather. So you can see I've got the elastics in here as usual. I've got some rocks to get the corners where I want them. I've got a little bit of living space in there, but basically I'm fully covered. If I wanted to make this even more windproof, then I would just drop some rocks on here and here and just drop the whole thing straight down, but then you start getting some unpleasant sort of condensation effects and so on. I do like to have a little bit of air in there, but you could see that we could easily tamp this down some more. At the front here, we've got the head very well protected from the wind, massive boulder on here, and underneath we have our little sleep setup, and it's actually relatively roomy. You can definitely be doing with that. Putting this backpack by your head, and then your sleeping bag and all that stuff goes in the the bivy. So that's the way I would use a big poncho like that, just to make a really bomb-proof shelter. Obviously, what you can do when you're setting up like this is to, if you're not really quite sure of the weather, basically set up your storm shelter and make it so that you can easily just take it down, so that you can sleep under the stars, you can get all your happy groovy stuff. But if the weather is bad, it's very quick to pull the tarp over and get some shelter. So let's see how that looks. So here you see it's very, very, very easy just to have that thing semi-set up already, so that you have your nice, you know, looking at the stars stuff and all that. But if the weather, you know, if it gets bad, it's just a matter of, essentially, it's a matter of one carabiner out here. So if it then gets bad, you basically have that carabiner and this carabiner, just a clip. If you wanted to be particularly good about it, you would add your little side pull out here. You should really be able to tie all the knots that you need to tie with one hand. And already you're in this bomber setup again. Mm-hmm. So there's really no need to ever get caught out by the storm. You just need to prepare beforehand and think about things. So set your tarp up, your poncho up, like it's going to be hideous, and then just undo it, flip it to the side, everything is good. Again, the use of the elastic band, the elastic shock cord here, super, super useful in so many ways for managing tarps and tents and things like this. So yeah, I usually have one strong ABS tent peg with me. You can also use it for like making the holes in the ground and then pulling out and putting a slightly less strong peg in, or a piece of wood or whatever. But yeah, just one of these, useful for lots of things. So let's talk about the bivy bag. This is a British military MTP, multi-terrain pattern. I really like this bivy bag because it is super lightweight, very robust, not indestructible. So I do put my three-quarter length Z rest underneath here. I don't use Gore-Tex in the winter because the pores will tend to get coated in ice and then the breathability just diminishes radically. But in this transitional period where it's raining and wet and windy, and it's 5 degrees plus, now it's -5 degrees, now everything's wet, now everything's frozen, this is actually the most dangerous time for hypothermia. I would much prefer to have -25 degrees cold, dry weather than +5, -5 wet and windy. It's just the worst. But that's what this setup is all for. So by the time I'm ready to go to bed, my summer sleeping bag is already inside the bivy bag. I've usually either got a mat with me, or if I'm in a forest like this, then I'll make a trapper bed. So I'll put two sticks along, a big pile of leaf duff like this, a couple more branches across the top to keep the insulation, and then some more leaf duff. Here we have plenty, so I would be very comfortable with that. But I take that Z rest with me anyway, for all the reasons that we talked about before. So what do? Well, I obviously have my hot water bottle. That will have been inside my sleeping bag at least a quarter of an hour before me, so that everything is nice and warm. And this makes a huge difference. This is 3 to 4 hours of really proper, good warmth. If you can make a hot water and put it in a sealed container that you can put in close to your body, you have won. Because even if you only have a jacket, even if you only got your loden or whatever, if you can make hot water, you put that right between your femoral arteries, between your legs, you put it against your belly, the external heat source, it makes a huge difference. So you put this in, you get this nice and hot. My test for whether it's too hot for my to use is basically if I can touch this with my normal leather gloves on. So with these thin leather gloves, if I can hold this with my leather gloves with no problem, then it won't melt my sleeping bag. quite an important thing. Another useful aspect of loden and woolen stuff is that you can actually put this kind of very hot water bottle directly into the main belly pocket of this, and you've got a hand warmer and it keeps your body heat in. So the hot water bottle, totally key. Of course you can use hot rocks as well. Again, make sure that you can hold them indefinitely with a thin leather glove. So the hot water bottle's in there. I might have been sitting up with the poncho already, with my poncho liner, with my serape, with my candle in my pot, so I'm likely to be nice and warm. I've moved around a bit just before bed, and I have eaten and drank plenty if at all possible. I can use this this camo scarf here. It's just a typical something that you might have with you. Wrap this around your waist inside your clothing. So you just wrap this around your torso as many times as it goes, tuck it inside your trousers. It makes an enormous difference. All of the kidneys, lower back and hips covered and really warmly packed with one of these, or with a merino scarf like I showed you in the other video, but some way of getting some warmth around your kidneys. You can also use this to wrap this thing in, to hold this thing against your body with, basically some kind of a scarf mechanism. So, other things we have to play with. The hat, of course you wear your hat to bed, but also, and here we have once again, the ghillie blanket. So the ghillie blanket, it's lots of loft. Why not put that thing inside your bivy bag, between your sleeping bag and the bivy? So what does that bring us? Well, it brings us at least an additional so much of loft. Imagine a sleeping bag this thick, how much difference that would make to your warmth. It also gives a bit of space for the moist air that's coming off of you, because you do perspire in the night. The moist air goes through your clothing, it goes through your sleeping bag. Now it has a little bit more space before it starts hitting the Gore-Tex membrane. So that just keeps the damp that might form on the inside of the membrane a little bit away from your body. So you can absolutely use this as an additional source of warmth, as an insulation, to help keep you warm in your bivy bag. So it's another way of avoiding having to take a heavier sleeping bag. You can take a woobie, or maybe like a loden poncho, and one or a couple of these. The other use for this, and one thing that that disturbs greatly, at least disturbs me when I'm sleeping in a bivy bag, is what to do with my breathing condensation. So I've got my hat on, you know, for sleeping. So I've got my hat on for sleeping, I've got my hood up, I've got my whoopee hood, I've got my summer sleeping bag inside of here. I'm gonna get crawled down inside of the bivy. So I'm here inside the bivy bag, I'm warm, everything's great, but I'm gonna have an issue with managing the condensation of my breath, because it's just that cold outside, and I try to have to figure out what to do to cover my head without breathing inside the Gore-Tex, and without breathing inside my sleeping bag or inside my serape here. So the challenge is how to make a microclimate for your head without disrupting the functioning of the sleeping bag or the bivy. And again here, the ghillie blanket has a very, very great use, because all you do is you drop this thing over you. Anyway, great for concealment. And then you simply lift this thing over your head like that, and you put your boots along the side here, or your trekking stick. Now you have very good cover for your head. You have a microclimate that also keeps the bugs off, very useful in certain circumstances. And you are
basically protected from the condensation that would otherwise form on your sleeping bag will now form on the outside of this. Plus, it kind of just keeps the wind off. It just makes a little bit of enclosure, and it allows you to be very, very comfortable in your sleeping without having to really close up the bivy bag at all. So another great use for the Ghillie blanket. Gets very warm inside of there. You can also do this, by the way, with a mesh scarf. It's not quite as great because obviously it's smaller. You have to think a bit more about how to do it, but you can. You can also do this with a mesh scarf if you haven't already wrapped it around your body. But basically the idea is to make a shroud that will make a little bit of a microclimate for you and just make the transition from the sleeping bag, bivy environment and the outside environment just a little bit less radical. So, you can also, of course, like you can see here, this tarp that I set up, you can just fold it back, you know? It's a nice little windbreak like this. If then in the night, the storm really would heavily come, very, very easy for me to, without actually getting up much, squirm around, stay inside the bivy bag, squirm around and basically lock this all down so that we don't have any problems and I don't have to get wet. Because even if it now starts hosing it down with rain, the bivy bag is waterproof. So as long as I can actually stay inside of that and do most of the tasks from being inside the bivy bag still, we're in a good space. Because when it starts hosing it down with rain, what you last thing you want is your sleeping bag to get wet. You need to stay as much of your body inside the bivy as possible. Maybe even lock it up around your chest up here so that you can just have your arms free to do what you need to do. If you're in a Durvan bag, of course, it's an entirely different story, but this is about how to live in a bivy bag. So, Ghillie blanket for microenvironment around your head and additional warmth. As a poncho liner, you can of course wrap your torso with this thing as well. It just becomes hugely warm then. And that's basically what I wanted to show you today. So go out there, get in the forest. You really can be comfortable in this sort of get up, even with very, very bad weather. Think about using this Ghillie blanket in new and innovative ways. Show me, make some videos, tell me what you're doing. Show me your ideas, and you know we're trying to figure out how to do these things, and best of all is to do that together. So see you in the next one. Have a good time outdoors. I'm gonna get some sleep.